Ornithology is my life's calling. I've been fascinated with birds ever since I was a little boy, enamored by their power to spread their wings and fly distances unfathomable to man. I have traveled the length and breadth of the country in search of rare birds, and wherever I have been so far, I have been truly lucky. I'm hoping for the same today as I travel to Kakinada, a port town on the coastline of Andhra Pradesh, where I am heading now. I wonder what surprises are in store for me there. The first surprise is surely the idea for me to go inside a factory to see the birds. But I'm very excited because I'm told I could catch a glimpse of the very rare Pacific golden plover. But I wonder, how can I spot birds inside a fertilizer factory? A bird's paradise inside a factory? Here is something you don't get to see every day. I am eager to get started. This is one trip I am not going to forget. Rather than trudging through mud tracks and wooden forests, I am walking on well-built pathways through a factory surrounded by acres of greenery. Workmen in hard hats going about their day, while the birds peacefully hover over the treetops. Such a unique way to coexist with nature. Wait, how did they do this? How did a chemical factory attract birds? Is this kind of coexistence possible? How does one sustain such a wonderful ecological balance? What do they manufacture in this factory? What are their future plans? Coromandel International Limited, a part of the Murugappa Group, is the second largest manufacturer of phosphatic fertilizers in India. The facility here in Kakinada began operations in the year 1986 with a production capacity of 300,000 tons, which has now been scaled up to 19 lakh tons.
The company's history dates back to nearly 230 years ago when EID Parry was started. EID Parry was one of the first companies to bring in fertilizer into India. It was in the 1980s that EID Parry and Murugappa Group acquired Coromandel Fertilizer, and subsequently Coromandel acquired Godavari, and that is what is the total picture of Coromandel Fertilizer today. Broadly, we are an India-focused group and largely started off with indigenizing production on products that were imported, then grew to size to become either the number one or number two player regionally or nationally in each of our product segments. We have gradually grown to an export situation where we are now in a few of our products become a global player as well.
Because of the need to produce more food, because there is more number of mouths to feed, and then there is each mouth is now eating more because of the purchasing power, you need a lot of food production. We may need maybe 10 or 20 times more land than what is being available today to produce. If you look at the crop requires what are called primary nutrients and secondary nutrients and tertiary nutrients. The primary nutrients are N, P and K. The secondary ones are sulfur, boron, manganese. Then you've got tertiary nutrients.
In India, two types of fertilizers are primarily used: urea-based fertilizer and NPK fertilizer. What is the basic difference between these two kinds? NPK fertilizer is a complex fertilizer comprising three primary nutrients required for healthy plant growth: nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. The agriculture industry relies heavily on the use of NPK fertilizers to meet global food demands and ensure healthy crops, while urea fertilizers provide only the essential nitrogen to soil. Coromandel International specializes in the manufacturing of different grades of NPK fertilizers. Now, let us find out more about NPK fertilizers. Just like human beings require a combination of nutrients, such as carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, etc., crops and plants also need a combination of nutrients for healthy growth and yield. The primary nutrients which crops require for their growth are N, nitrogen, P, phosphorus, and K, potassium. These are required in varying quantities depending on the type of crop. Now I get a clear picture on why different fertilizers are applied to different crops. For instance, the rice crop would require fertilizer which helps the growing of the grain. Therefore, fertilizers with higher level of potassium would be used here, with lesser levels of nitrogen and phosphorus. The facility at Coromandel, Kakinada manufactures different varieties of NP and NPK fertilizers. Each variant is customized to meet the specific nutritional requirements of the crops. Each variant of fertilizer requires to be manufactured differently, keeping in mind the ratios and proportions of N, P and K. At Coromandel International in Kakinada, 9 different variants of NPK fertilizers are manufactured. It is purely a processing plant wherein readily processed raw materials are combined in the required proportions to produce the desired variant of the fertilizer. Here is an interesting trivia on fertilizers for you. On an average, out of every 10 bags of NPK fertilizers sold in India, 4 to 5 bags are produced by Coromandel International Limited. I bet you didn't know that. So how are these NPK fertilizers manufactured? What are the raw materials that are required? What is the process? The manufacturing process begins with the procurement of raw materials. For manufacturing NPK fertilizers, the key raw materials are sourced from across the world from countries like South Africa, Tunisia, Jordan, etc. Therefore, there is a high dependency on the port network. Reason why port cities are chosen for setting up fertilizer plants. This ensures easy access to raw materials and better connectivity. Other plants of Coromandel International Limited are also located in port cities or towns like Vizag and Ennore near Chennai.
Domestically, there is no potash available in India. As far as phosphates are concerned, we have low-grade rock in Rajasthan, which does not suit phosphoric acid manufacture.
The main raw materials required for manufacturing of NPK fertilizers are ammonia in liquid form, phosphoric acid, sulfuric acid, urea, and potash. The liquid ammonia, phosphoric acid and sulfuric acid are transported directly from the ship which docks at the port via pipelines to the storage tanks in the plant. The urea and potash, which are in solid form, are loaded in trucks and transported to the raw material storage area. The next step in the manufacturing process is to transport the raw materials from the storage area to the main production facility. The manufacturing process is carried out end to end by a series of conveyor systems. Each system is referred to as a train.
We have 3 production facilities, that is A train, B train, C train. This raw material enters into the production facilities, where it will be mixed based on the requirement of the different grades.
The facility at Coromandel Kakinada has 3 trains which operate on a daily basis. Each train can manufacture a particular variant of NPK fertilizer at a given time, which is pre-decided by the team. The actual manufacturing process of the fertilizer takes place in a massive rotating chamber, which is literally the heart of the plant and also known as the granulator. It is in this chamber that the chemical reaction between the raw materials takes place.
Granulation is the main thing, wherein the chemical reactions take place. It converts the raw material into the NPK, phosphatic fertilizer product.
The next big important part of the plant is the control room. If the granulator is the heart of the plant, then the control room is its brain. It is from here the process of manufacturing is monitored and adjusted as required.
Once it is produced, it will be taken to dryer where it has to be dried. Then it has to be cleaned and segregated to good quality product and fine product. Again, good quality product will be sent to the final product area. We call it as the final bulk storage area.
Anything over or under the prescribed size is sent back for reprocessing. To maintain the highest quality standard, the fertilizer is checked by the in-house quality team every 30 minutes to ensure only the best quality fertilizer that meets all the specs is sent for packaging.
We are ZLD plant, that is zero liquid discharge. You cannot find any of the liquid effluent going out of the practice premises anywhere. All the process liquids, all the process effluent are based, either it will be recycled or reused.
Such sweet words for me and the birds. Hats off to the management and the team at Coromandel for being conscious about the impact caused by production and supporting sustainable practices at all times. The finished product stored in the bulk storage area has now reached the penultimate stage of the process, packaging. Fertilizers are packed in 50 kg bags at the bagging facility and are moved through rail wagons and trucks to markets across the country based on the plan chalked out by the Coromandel sales and marketing team. Talking of the end users, the farmers, Coromandel in the year 2006, as part of its plan to reach out and be accessible to farmers, established retail centers under the name Mana Growmore Centers in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana and Namma Growmore Centers in Karnataka.
From our retail centers, we actually advise farmers as to what crop they should grow in that area, what mix of fertilizer they should use, what is lacking in their soil, and what are the sort of techniques they need to adopt.
Coromandel's retail centers are located at the Mandal headquarters. Each retail center has an average area of 1,750 square feet, serving an area of 30 to 40 villages and about 5,000 farmer families. The Growmore retail stores comprise of the largest rural retail chain in the country, covering over 1 million square feet spread across 800 plus Growmore centers in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Karnataka. From the nutrition mix required to how to fight pests and insects, and any and all questions are answered at the Growmore centers. Also, an interactive kiosk is available to the farmer at the Growmore center for him to understand plant nutrition management better. From receiving expert advice on various farming related topics to purchasing fertilizers and pesticides. Sowing to harvesting made easy at the one-stop shop, the Growmore Center. Yet another initiative by Coromandel through the Growmore Centers is soil testing. As the name suggests, soil experts test the health of the soil and provide the farmer with a soil health card, which gives information on the composition of the soil. The soil experts team go farm to farm to conduct this test. That is, it happens at the farm with the farmer by using a soil health testing kit. The soil health card gives information on the organic and inorganic content of the soil, basis which the farmer is advised on what supplements need to be applied to the soil for better yield and improved soil health.
We then advise the farmer based on his soil test, what is the mix of fertilizer he should use, what is the blend he should use, and what crop he should grow.
Coromandel Kakinada, a mega factory which works for the farming community, has been a source of employment for over 1,000 employees at the plant. A factory which manufactures 9 different variants of fertilizers. A factory with the highest regard for quality and safety standards. A factory known for its environment-friendly practices And last but not the least, back to my favorite part, a factory with a bird's paradise in its premises. The birth of the bird's paradise started with the noble thought of conserving the biodiversity and the fragile ecosystem around the plant. In the beginning, the area around the plant was marshy and waterlogged. Today, because of the efforts of Coromandel, the area has transformed into a serene, lush green belt with dense flora and plentiful water, making it the ideal habitat for several bird species. To ensure the safety of the birds and to understand them better, Coromandel has joined hands with the Agri Foundation, the East Godavari River Estuarine Ecosystem. Agri Foundation is an NGO Coromandel is working with for ecological conservation and biodiversity. 50% of the plant area, which is almost 350 acres, has been converted into a green belt.
We as a responsible corporate, Murugappa Group and Coromandel, we are one step ahead in ensuring safe operation. Whatever the Pollution Control Board norm sets, we operate at 40% below the norm sets. That is our strength, that is our operation philosophy, that is where our way forward and sustainability operation comes into place. It may be the first of its kind of this type of any fertilizer industries. We are getting birds from overseas countries. They are our guest. We call it as Coromandel's guest.
The unique guests of Coromandel Kakinada flock from far and wide for their annual retreat. An estimated 97 different species of birds have been recorded to visit Kakinada, out of which 24 species are long-distance migratory birds traveling from as far as Siberia. Additionally, 13 species breed here, making it the largest breeding grounds for the grey heron, painted storks and darter. It is also the second largest breeding grounds for the Asian open-bill storks in the East Godavari district. Currently, the total number of birds at the paradise accounts to 4,000 during the peak season between November and March.
As per the bioconservation specialists, around 269 species in East Godavari, whereas out of that, 103 are in Coromandel. Birds are more sensitive to its surroundings. So as long as if it is not polluted, they are more comfortable to come and say and breed. It indicates our operations are more ecological, eco-friendly operations.
This would not have been possible without the support, the initiative, the involvement, the dedication, commitment, and diligence of all our colleagues in our Kakinada plant. And they do this voluntarily outside of their working hours to ensure that the world will be a better place to live in.
I can only describe what I am feeling in one word: amazing. I only wish more and more companies follow this in the future. Coromandel has set new standards in sustainable practices and conservation efforts. Apart from the breathtaking birds paradise we just saw, Coromandel has other corporate social responsibility initiatives as well.
Social responsibility goes hand in hand with our business responsibility. And we would like to make an impact on society as much as we would like to make an impact in the way we run business.
Coromandel focuses primarily on education of the girl child through scholarships to deserving students, healthcare by supporting the neonatal ward at the Kakinada Government Hospital and through medical centers and mobile medical vans, community development through specialized outreach centers. A future-ready Coromandel is constantly looking to innovate and explore the best way to meet the needs of the farmer and the farming community. With expertise in fertilizers and crop protection, the company has now scaled up their efforts in organic fertilizers, water-soluble fertilizers and farming equipment, making great strides already. Coromandel International Limited is definitely future positive about agriculture in India.
I would like to see a farmer dressing like us and no staying in an air-conditioned environment, and then make the application of the fertilizer, nutrition, etc. on a pressing of a button. That should be the aim at the end of the day.
the dream of a food-secure India and world is rapidly becoming a reality with sustainable and responsible practices of companies like Coromandel International Limited, one of India's leading fertilizer manufacturer.
So to us, sustainability is all-encompassing and extremely important. Sustainability is all about ensuring that current generations are supported and future generations also will see the fruits of such effort. The initiatives that we are taking and we continue to take in and around our factory with the involvement of all our employees, that we have a sustainable future. And we will try and ensure this so that we invite all the wonderful hobbyists, bird watchers, and ornithologists to come and visit us and advise us as to what work we can do to ensure sustainability of not only the environment around us, but society as a whole.
An unforgettable trip which will be imprinted in my memory forever. From the beautiful birds to the top-of-the-line innovations in fertilizer manufacturing and farmer care, Coromandel Kakinada is truly a trendsetter. I'm definitely coming back for round two. What about you?